I was playing around with this oscilloscope, and then I was wondering, can it pick up the 49 megahertz from this remote control for a toy, just holding it near? And sure enough, it does pick something up. And zooming way, 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 way out, it looks like the modulation is just a matter of turning the carrier on and off. Now, I've used a Raspberry Pi Pico before to get 62.5 megahertz for testing a scope. Question is, can I get the 49 megahertz to control this toy? Except it's not exactly 49 megahertz, they use 49.83 or 49.86 typical. But the channel width for these remote controls is only about 30 kilohertz, so if I was 20 kilohertz off, I'm pretty sure that wouldn't work. Now, for outputting PWM on this, I can divide the clock by 2, too high, or 3, too low. But I can set the Pico's main clock frequency to something else, and then going at exactly half of that, I can get 49 megahertz. And the scope's frequency counter does confirm I got 49 megahertz. But I can't use that frequency counter to check the frequency of this remote, because this never transmits continuously. And looking at the waveform here, I can't use the cursors to measure this accurately enough to figure out exactly where it is. But I've got another idea. If I just change the horizontal scale to something slow enough, my sample rate will drop. So now, cranking it way down, I'm at 50 megasamples per second, and I'm capturing 49 megahertz here, so that'll cause some aliasing. So now if I just use the cursors to mark one period of this aliased waveform, and it says that is 138.9 kilohertz, so that's how far off we are off of 50 megahertz. And subtracting that from 50 megahertz, we get 49.861 megahertz. So that tells me this thing operates probably at 49.86 megahertz. So I could try to set the system clock to twice that and then set the PWM, but I get this. It's not a frequency I can set it to. But trying it with 49.8, that does work. And the scope confirms 49.8 megahertz. But that's a full two channels off. This thing will never accept that. But my PWM doesn't have to be super clean. If I just kind of play with pulses, I can approximate a frequency that is a non-integer divisor of my clock frequency. So here's approximating this sine wave, which has got a period of 2.5 times our bit period, and I can kind of approximate that to follow that roughly. So I could use a slightly more complicated pattern to get 49.86 megahertz off of a 125 megahertz clock. It's not a clean signal, but it does have that 49.86 megahertz that the thing looks for, and anything that's out of band, it'll just ignore. But then I realized if I overclock the Pico by just a little bit to 150 megahertz, I get a 3-to-1, which is much nicer. And here I'm actually dividing the frequency by 3.1 because I have to be not an integer divisor. So here we go high, high, low, high, high, low, etc. until we get to here where we have high, high, low, low, and then high, low, low, high, low, low, because we needed to shift the phase a little bit to get back in sync. And then once again, we get to here, we need to do another one of these things to get kind of back in sync. And as long as I can place my phase adjustments just right, I should be able to approximate any frequency. And this is something that the PIO state machines on the Pi Pico are useful for. Now, I didn't really want to get into programming those things, learning yet another assembly language, but at some point playing with ChatGPT, it just suggested, well, just use the PIO for that, and here's a program for that. Now, it turns out the ChatGPT program didn't actually work, but it gave me a starting point, as in, okay, it's actually not that difficult, it's pretty easy to create PIO state machines from MicroPython. And here's my state machine after much playing around with it that creates the 0100100110111, does the alternating pattern, and I can specify my counts here to say how often to switch. Right now it's set really short. And looking at the output on the scope, here goes from 001001 and then 11011011 and then switching again here to the other phase. And now with the loop counts tweaked for how often to do the phase shift, the scope now says 49.8607 megahertz. So I hit my carrier frequency within 700 hertz or 0.0014%. And looking at the modulation protocol coming out of this thing, it seems to always be four long pulses followed by a number of short pulses. No matter what it is, it's just the only thing that varies is the number of short pulses after a long pulse. Now the modulation happens at a much, much lower rate, so I can just use straight up Python to turn the state machine on and off right here. And the simplest command is four long pulses followed by 10 short ones, and that turns one of the wheels. So here's my toy. I'll push F5 to run that, and there it goes. Now, all the commands that it sends are always four long pulses followed by a certain number of short ones, and rather than trying to count them on the scope to figure out which is which, I'm just trying all of them and see what the thing does. Right there, I got one. Another one. Another valid code. Another one. Another one. And here's all the pulse counts that it responds to. And now I've set this to pulse every once in a while, and I want to see how far I can make this work. The Pi is right here. Let's see how far I can get away from it, and it still works. Whoa! So, I'm in the corner of the basement now. Oh, it lost it. Oh, there. So that's about the range. That's, I don't know, about 6 or 7 meters. So this is so cool that this actually works so well. Although what I'm sending would never pass FCC regulations because what I'm sending is rather dirty, but I'm not really a transmitter, am I? All I'm doing is just toggling one IO line really fast. Although I do require this lead hanging off the IO line. If I pull that out, my range is less than 2 meters. But for 49 megahertz transmissions, I could probably get much more range by using a much longer wire. And unfortunately, this thing is way too twitchy to make it do anything predictable programmatically. And it works much better in wheelie state too than on its front wheels. Now it'd be pretty easy to transmit in the AM band with this thing because that's around 1 megahertz. The FM band, you know, around 100 megahertz, it's a bit more difficult. But that works too. So there, that's on, and I'll run my program here, push F5, and it's gone. To hit around 100 megahertz, I need to run the main clock actually twice as fast, so overclocking it to almost 200 megahertz, which still barely works, and those FM channels are a lot wider, which means I can just set the main clock to about twice that, and then set the PWM frequency to half of that. So now running, and now let's run my modulation code, and it's gone. And now I'm just modulating it by changing the main clock frequency and continuing to use a divisor of 2 with a PWM. And that is actually pretty messy because it always takes it about 75 microseconds to adjust to a new clock frequency. So really messy, not suitable for transmitting any sort of specific sounds.